कि हमको इमोशनल इशू रिजॉल्व करें. समटाइम्स इट टेक्स पीपल टू अदर सिस्टम्स एंड डायरेक्टली टू एलोपैथी टू अ गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ पर्सन हैव अ यूट्राइन ट्यूमर, और इट टेक्स यू डायरेक्टली टू एन ऑप्थल्मोलॉजिस्ट बिकॉज यू आर हैव एन इम्पेंडिंग रेटिनल डिटैचमेंट. सो एट दैट टाइम द कॉन्शियसनेस प्रायोरिटी इज नॉट कि हम अपना इमोशनल इशू रिजॉल्व करें. सो इट टेक्स केयर ऑफ एंड रिस्पेक्ट्स एंड गिव्स इक्वल इंपॉर्टेंस टू एलोपैथी इन डिफरेंट सिचुएशंस. सो नाउ आई विल जस्ट इनवाइट डॉक्टर पंकज. So he's, we both have been doing integrative medicine practice. He's in Jaipur and he's been doing wonderful work for people. The story for him is that, I had experienced body talk and I was already aware of it. So I was pushing him along and he was not very interested. He did the body talk exercise. He said, Mangu, Jaipur mein sab nahi chalega. Jaipur mein, people come for me for 5 minutes and mere paas itna time nahi hoga main sab karu. और किसी के पास सुनने का इतना टाइम ही नहीं है. बट आई सम हाउ मैनेज टू कन्विंस हिम एंड प्लस देयर वाज दैट इन अ वॉइस एंड लैंग्वेज सेड चलो चलते हैं. एंड देन देयर आल्सो फॉर द फर्स्ट टू डेज ही वाज वेरी क्रिटिकल. ही वाज वेरी वेरी क्रिटिकल ऑफ द होल थिंग के एंड ही वाज आस्किंग सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस एंड ही वाज इन अ वे इंटरप्टिंग द होल क्लास बिकॉज ही डिडंट हैव फेथ कंप्लीट फेथ इन द सिस्टम. एंड but the teacher was so gracious and she patiently answered every question that he had. And now he will share with you what now he's doing.
Okay. Hello everyone. First of all, thank you to all of you to who all are coming to this session, because it shows that you have some kind of different aura with you which attached to this path. So I'm Dr. Pankaj. My journey is quite different. Me and Mankul are Emersonian batchmates. 2004 batch. I did my MP in this from AIIMS and MD from PGI. And I'm in both spiritual and holistic journey for last so many years, you can say. And gradually I shifted from allopathy to more wholesome, including Ayurveda, diet, and homeopathy also for last 2 years. And gradually I realized that everything has a power to heal. There's nothing which is wrong, nothing which is right. It's all about to combine in holistic way. So my question after going through all this, why, it's good to combine, but how do I decide? How do I decide that which pathy I should use? So it's most difficult to answer because in a way Ayurveda works, homeopathy works. Even how many of you feel better when you go to temple or any holy place? Just raise your hands. So what's the reason behind this? Can we explain it?
Energy.
One thing is, I think there are two reasons. One thing is faith. If somebody is Muslim is going to temple, he won't get any and that kind of feeling. If somebody is Hindu going to masjid, won't get that kind of feeling, right? So we always know that there are two components. One is faith and one is energy. So that is collectively giving something good to our body and then we are feeling good. So Mankul has exposed to me about this, and with the help of TK Adelby also last March we had done the body access, and I came to know about, we went to Africa, and believe me, what you have said at this point of time, hearing all this, I have the same while doing the course. So I am also very very left brainer, both right brainer too. I have done the scan of my brain and brain imaging and brain mapping also. So I am basically more of right brainer, but left logical brain is also working in some extent. So I was too critical in going, how can this work? How can you find all this reason and you can go into past and you can say, this event has happened in that age or years. Like I was given example while I was doing the course that somebody who was doing the body session and she must be around 60 and there was pop-up while doing the body talk. You had one event on 26 July 1972. So at that time she must be around 19 or 20. So she had no idea what had happened that day. So she went to home. Then she asked her mother, mom, what happened on that day? I'm not remembering now, what's happened? Then her mother told, so this was coming on body talk. You got gang raped on that day. And she won't believe it. She had forgot about it because it's been 40 years now. So he went exactly the known, can't find the date, but the body talk practitioner can pick up the date on what exactly that happened. So this is the power of body talk. Now I would be sharing one, some of my experiences of patients, and we can start with this. Play any. I have no schedule. Just play any video.
Okay, video.
Then we can discuss in detail. Okay, what's how it's working. Yeah, play this one.
Hi everyone. I am a 32-year-old practicing ophthalmologist. I was having some emotional issues and some physical issues for which I presented to Dr. Pankaj Verma. He has performed something called a body talk on me. Body talk is a process where the practitioner tries to pick up body signals from your body, and what is surprising is that without even discussing in detail what are the issues going on with my body, Dr. Pankaj during the body talk was able to tell me what kind of issues I am suffering. Especially, for example, I was having this back pain. I never told him what kind of back pain and what is the level of the back pain that I was having, and he was rightly able to tell where the back pain is and also what is the cause of the back pain. I was having sleep issues which I had not discussed with him because I thought that they were not important, and he has also confirmed, he also confirmed with me that yes, you are having sleep issues, and I was surprised to know that how he got to know all the things which I have not even discussed with him. So through body talk, I think he was able to get a holistic diagnosis of my body. Also, after the body talk, he has performed some healing, after which I am feeling good, and I really, I'm really thankful for getting to know Dr. Pankaj. Thank you so much.
So basically, this has done. I've done only this last Sunday only. I was in Delhi for the Amazonians for Ayurveda meeting. She's a good friend of mine, and the things come out that she had a fear of rejection. Me and Mankul also know that Talvi, she is our best friend. And we know that she is very, very bold and confident lady. And then she had a fear of rejection. So when it pop out with while doing the body talk, I was surprised. Like, do you have fear of rejection? I was doubting it. But then she told, how do you get to pick another? Actually, this is the reason I portray myself as a bold. So that people won't judge me, and they won't reject me. That's why she used to done everything. Sometimes we do in contradiction. If we have a fear of rejection, then we will try to do something of everything. We will put more energy into it, so that people won't reject us. So these other things can happen, and it can happen with anybody. One feedback I haven't recorded and just came to my mind, and say I was also surprised while doing that. How many of you heard about the lung cancer? Everybody I think heard about it. And at the age of 35, anybody who knows this person, so one of my friends who is in Kota, so he got some fluid in the lungs. So we call it, as a doctor, most of you are a doctor, we call it pleural effusion. So it came out to be malignant pleural effusion. In some reports, there was suspicion of malignancy. He came to me in Jaipur to do the detailed workup with oncologist. Then he had fixed the meeting. He came to me. I did the body talk session. So it came out to be mesothelioma. How many of you heard about this term? As a doctor, I think doctors have heard of this. This is a very, very rare kind of cancer, which is done by of the mesothelial cells. It's like a lining of the lungs, and which is very, very limited. It is actually 1 to 5% of total lung cancer. So this came in body talk without even, it's came in the body talk. Then the issue is that he was not diagnosed, and I told him that you may have mesothelioma. I just came in the body talk. Then he went to Jaipur oncologist, and it was came out to be squamous cell carcinoma. Okay, but the people were in doubt because PET scan was done. PET scan showed there was no tumor at all in the body except lung. Again the biopsy was done and it was showing nothing. They went to Tata Memorial Mumbai, and it was came out to atypical squamous cell carcinoma. I am just labeling the term. There are different kind of lung cancer can be possibility. So the most common is lung adenocarcinoma. Finally, he went to Kokilaben, Mumbai, and it came out to adenocarcinoma of lung. Then again, people in doubt because adenocarcinoma of the limited to only one lung, causing only effusion at the age of 35, is quite rare. Then they have done the videoscopy. They have went inside and then put the video and pick out some cells. And finally, it came out to mesothelioma after spending 25 days and 5 lakhs rupees. So I have no idea how it has been done. Because while I was doing the session, can you show the body for this? Keep the open of the this portable image.
Okay.
Yeah, this one. So do you see this in the body chemistry? So he is working in thermal factory for last 10 years. So in my body talk, I have got pick up like he had a airborne allergen toxins in the body. So airborne allergen is the common cause. It's the cause of actually mesothelioma. Most common cause is asbestos. And asbestos, some painting or thermal lining has some chemicals which can cause this. So he was working in thermal factory, but not in the factory. He was working as an engineer and manager in charge of the whole the team. So that was quite shocking for me and shocking for that also. Okay, how can you pick up all these things in body talk? Do you see, I'm still in surprise mode.
Yeah. Can I just add to this?
Yeah.
This was great. But I just like to mention that this is energy medicine.
Yeah.
And sometimes we pick up the problems which have not occurred. Because in your astral body, the problem first comes in your astral body. So there are times you can pick up cellular disorders, things like that, even years before they have come, right?
Yeah.
Same like, you know, aura scan, but this time you got it right.
As a doctor, we all know that any kind of cancer cause go through so many processes, at least took 5 to 10 years to come in symptomatic form or then come in visible form. So everything is happening inside.
No, this one takes about more than 20 years because
yeah,
I worked with asbestos too.
That's great. So, those of you who are doctors and there was issues like most of body talk deals with the emotional aspect of it. So there is a book called The Theta Healing. It's by Vienna Stiebel. So Theta Healing, it's written there, all the emotional causes of anything. Like if you have fungal infection, so what's the emotional cause of it? If you have TB, what's the emotional cause of it? So those of you who want to learn about the emotional cause of the diseases, you can buy a book called The Theta Healing by Vienna Stiebel. Okay, next.
This is Anshul Singh, a single song writer from Mumbai. I just want to share my experience with the term called body talk. Last month, I was in Jaipur, my sister's house, and she told me about it. And I met Dr. Pankaj Verma, and I was laughing from inside, that how can it happen that without knowing anything, without any pre-discussion, he can tell me what is going on inside and what I'm doing with which thing. क्या महसूस कर रहा हूँ इनफैक्ट. सो ड्यूरिंग द होल सेशन वो मुझे बताते रहे कि क्या ये है, क्या ऐसा है, क्या वैसा है, क्या ये है. और मैं अंदर से ये फील कर रहा था कि ये तो सब चीज सच सच ही बता रहे हैं और मैंने तो कुछ डिस्कस भी नहीं किया इनके साथ. सो मतलब इट वॉज अ इनक्रेडिबल एक्सपीरियंस फॉर मी कि उन्होंने सब चीजें बताती चले गए और मुझे ये भी गाइड किया कि हाउ टू मूव ऑन और हाउ टू टैकल these situations. So thank you Dr. Pankaj Verma. Thank you guys. See you soon. Yeah.
Okay. So he is a professional singer in Mumbai and he is actually my brother-in-law. And I met him in the marriage last 6 years back. 6 years pehle isse mila tha. 6 years se he is in Mumbai and struggling and now it's a good successful. So when I was doing, he is very 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 rigid ke mujhe nahi karna hai. And matlab he just said ki ye kya bewakoofi hai matlab. इसमें क्या निकल के आने वाला है. एंड ही वाज इवन होल टाइम ही वाज लाफिंग व्हाइल लाइंग डाउन के मतलब क्या मतलब व्हाई आर यू डूइंग दिस, व्हाई आर यू डूइंग दिस. देन सम थिंग्स ग्रेजुअली कमिंग आउट एंड ही बिकम ग्रेजुअली सीरियस अबाउट इट. एंड यू वोंट बिलीव के ही हैज टू ही सडनली गॉट सीवियर पेन एब्डोमेन व्हाइल डूइंग द सेशन. ड्यूरिंग द सेशन ही हैज टू गो टू वॉशरूम टू रिलीज इट अप. Then one thing came out that in 2008, 10 years back, and again show that protocol. So he had a memory of someone who loved him. And she loves him a lot. मतलब ये body talk में so in 2008 somebody loved you and there is still emotion going on in your body. So he was saying के like हाँ मतलब maybe or may not be. Then he just spotted कि yes के there is one girl and who is still unmarried and still waiting for me के that maybe someday and he is in love with someone else. That yes, okay, maybe one day something can happen, and she's still waiting in Delhi for him. So he was shocked. Okay, how is it possible? Okay, that us ladki ka emotion meri body mein kya kar raha hai? So basically, it's not.
And he's your brother.
He is my brother. So. It's like then उसने मुझे बोला कि ठीक है मतलब हाँ उसने मतलब मैं जब कॉलेज में था तब से वो मेरे प्यार में है एंड बट मेरे को उससे कभी अट्रैक्शन नहीं हुआ एंड तो लिव इट तो उसके बाद जब ये पॉप अप हुआ एंड दिस सेशन हैज बीन टेकन वन मंथ बैक एक महीने में एंड द इशू इज के इट्स नाउ कमिंग टू क्लोजर जो हमने बताया कि चीज़ें लास्ट जो हमने मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट पर डिस्कस किया था कि चीज़ें आपकी अवेयरनेस में आ जाती हैं So once you know कि हाँ someone's energy is still affecting you, we all know हम दुआ और बददुआ पे believe करते हैं कि किसी की को हमने नुकसान पहुंचाया है तो negative energy will get transferred to us. If someone if we have done the good deed, the good energy will transfer to us. That's why we tell के अच्छा करना है बुरा नहीं करना. So what happened in the same time that girl also came to Jaipur. बेसिकली मेरा ब्रदर लोग इसलिए आया था क्योंकि माई वन सिस्टर इन लॉ सीवियरली सिक सो आई जस्ट इनवाइटेड हर कि आप यहाँ आइए यहाँ पे आपका इलाज करवाइए तो वो दिल्ली से उससे मिलने आई एंड समथिंग हैपेंड एंड दे हैवन टॉक्ड एंड नाउ इट्स केम टू क्लोजर शी दैट गर्ल इज गेटिंग मैरिड नाउ एंड ब्रदर लॉ माई ब्रदर लॉ ही इज इन लव फॉर लास्ट थ्री फोर नाइन ईयर्स एंड ही वॉज नॉट गेटिंग मैरिड एंड नाउ ही इज प्लानिंग टू गेट मैरिड So once you know this ki yes something it is there and which is not I didn't have idea ki that is having so much influence on my soul. So emotional thing have great and so many we all know ki like koi gira koi girne se usko pata bhi chala uth ke chala gaya koi gira uska complete ankle fracture ho gaya koi gira usko immediately forearm fracture ho gaya so we all know ki everyone has a different kind of bioenergy or strength So it's all about so many things beyond allopathy, which actually works.
See, one-sided love I can understand.
Yeah.
But how can one-sided love have an effect on the guy?
Yeah.
Had it been adequate love from both ends,
can I explain that?
Because that way, you know.
Out of context. Okay. I know what you mean. That is called the invading entity, right?
Okay.
It comes. It's a part of body talk too. It's an invasive thing, right? So she has projected it, so it gets attached. So there is a way to break that down. So it is like what tantrics do. How do they affect? They throw some evil curse. So everything need not be evil. There can be good things, attachment. So these are called attached entities.
Yeah. Basically,
they
affect. In his mind, he knows that girl loves him for last so many years, and she is still waiting. So she somehow he also has some emotional guilt. Yes, I don't love him, so I can't reciprocate that love that she is giving to me. In that case, okay. Next. So I know most of the doctors. So it's more difficult to convince doctors through body talk, and then when they have good experience, then it feel good. So please. So she is a head of department, retired head of department from gynecology from SMS Jaipur.
Officer retired हो गई हूँ और मैंने राजस्थान हॉस्पिटल ज्वाइन किया है एक साल से डॉक्टर पंकज से मेरा संपर्क हुआ है मैंने बॉडी टॉक के बारे में उनसे बात करी थी मुझे शीशे में पहले कुछ भी पता नहीं था और एक लास्ट वन मंथ से मेरी काफ़ी तबीयत खराब थी मुझे बुखार और अस्थमा हो गया था उससे मैं काफ़ी परेशान रहने लगी थी डिप्रेशन सा होने लगा था
show the protocol. I think that was non-audible. So she had an issue with the basically back pain. She had an issue of allergy. She had an issue of asthma, and she had an issue of insomnia. So there's not only emotional part that can be healed, the physical elements can be touched upon with the body talk. So after the session, she gradually improved over the period of 5 to 10 days. And it's not like everything has gone, but it's now allergy. She was came up to having allergy with the dust and some more the house dust or something. Then she had an ego issue. She won't listen to anybody. During the whole day, she live in, because she was head of department. So she lived in authority mode. She retired and did almost 8 years now. But still she had the same issue. If anybody is not accepting her order, or anybody is just not willing to follow her instruction, she feel bad. In that way, she was getting lots of emotional charge, negative charge in her mind, that is disturbing her sleep. And so gradually she improved. It's all about one more case I want to share. Just I think 10 days back I got a case, and he got hiccups. He came to me from another district, and he was having hiccups for last 15 days. And he has tried almost 6 doctors, and but hiccups was not. It was completely resistant to any kind of drug that has been given. So he came to me for the medicine only. But I have done only the body chemistry part, this one. So we all know this hiccups is going on. Something wrong is going in the body. Either acidity or issue with the lungs, or issue with the vagus nerve, or maybe it's issue with the heart, which all this can cause hiccups or persistent irritation of all these things around that area, which can allow the diaphragm, which can cause hiccups. So in the body chemistry, what Dr. Suresh has taught, we had done the body access, the one day course. So we had learned about cortices to balance the brain. We all know we have a right brain, left brain, frontal lobe, occipital lobe, cortices, then limbic system, hypothalamus, everything is there. Then we try to balance all the system in harmony, basically. We all know they all work 24/7 whole life. But if they work in harmony, then chances that we feel good, chances we be being healthy increases. So similarly, cortices, then we do switching. Sometimes we get, our mind gets switched off. Like it's exhausted, or somebody has said something bad to us. Then we say, ki nahi yaar, mujhse kuch nahi hoga, mera dimag band hai. Kai baar hum aisa bolte hain. तो स्विच ऑफ को स्विच ऑन कैसे करना है, उसके कुछ टेक्निक्स हैं। सिमिलरली बॉडी केमिस्ट्री में कुछ भी आपको वायरल फीवर हुआ है या कोई एक्यूट इन्फेक्शन हुआ है, तो उससे डील करने के लिए आपकी बॉडी में जो कैपेसिटी है, आप उसको बॉडी केमिस्ट्री से इंक्रीज कर सकते हैं। उसका सिस्टम ये है कि यू पुट सम सलाइवा ऑन द नर्व बेसिकली। सो अल्टीमेटली ब्लड इज द थिंग विच क्योर एवरीथिंग, बट यू कांट कट योरसेल्फ इन ब्लड, देन वी टेक सलाइवा एज ए पार्ट ऑफ ब्लड। Ultimately, then saliva got charged up, which can help in targeting the infection and gradually clear it off from the body. So I've done the body chemistry to that guy, and he went home and he took one tablet, the same tablet, simple pantoprazole DSR, we all know, PPI, any acidity tablet, and his hiccups stopped immediately, just after taking one pill. And maybe that one pill works, or maybe that body talk works, I still don't know. That guy gradually come out to be having severe pulmonary tuberculosis, and that was the cause. I have done the test also. So I have done the CT scan after 4 days, which revealed all this. Okay, next. And first of all, most of you are thinking that we all are doctors or having some scientific background. When I was in Africa doing the body talk, we are the most difficult people who actually got it very, very late. Because other than us, nobody was doctors. There were, I think, 14 people in the group. 12 were non-doctors, non-medicals, and they are all doing very, very great job, because it's about the intuition. It's not about the logical mind. Knowledge can be gained, but...
I just like to add one thing. the simpler the person, if your brain is empty,
yeah,
it is very easy to teach you something. But their brains already got all this empty stuff. It's very difficult to tell them anything.
Another thing which our teacher taught us, the secret to body talk, is kiss.
Yeah.
Keep it simple and stupid.
Yeah, this is one more story which is very, very positive and inspiring. Mr. Tarun Toshniwal, he is a head of in charge of all the digital data of government basically. So his father is having Parkinson's disease. We all know about, anybody know about Parkinson? Everybody know about Parkinson's disease. Having some tremors and very, very difficult task to even move, some having a face like mask. So his father is 88 year old and he is having Parkinson for last 20 years. So and his father is a scientist, so his brain is working in absolutely good condition till now. Because Parkinson don't affect your brain, it's only affect your muscles and the body and anything which has to do with muscles and nervous system basically. So what happens, there is one chemical called dopamine, one chemical called acetylcholine in our body. And this disbalance and dopamine gradually cause shut down and only acetylcholine which is remaining, which actually cause Parkinson. So since gradually, in any advanced Parkinson, usually patients stop responding to all the treatment. It's been 20 years, so all the dopamine receptors have been gone. So no allopathy medicine was working. He came to me for a holistic solution in April 2019, this year. And I advised him to go to Ayurvedic treatment, and he was under treatment for Ayurveda. He had responded well for some 1 to 2 months, and again he stopped responding to that Ayurveda drugs also. Some more drugs were advised, but he was very, very skeptical decision ke whether I should take them or not, because they can cause harm also. So what happened, he has called me that my father has ko bahut zyada difficulty ho raha hai. Difficulty is limit, it's fine, but agar aapki swallowing ki muscle involved hai, you can't swallow the food. So it reached up to that level that he can't able to speak, he wouldn't able to swallow anything, and it was very having severe tremor and total not able to sleep at all. Then I told about the body talk that I've done this course. Then he just told me, can you try this body talk on my father? He was sure that it not gonna work, but it's a lot. Because nothing was working, so I think something can be working. So I came there, I went there, and I done the session. After that, I wouldn't hear even a single word from him for 7 days. So he is also very, very intellectual. So and then after 7 days, he called me, and he said that my father Parkinson has very, very dramatically improved the very same night that you had done the body talk. He able to speak. He was able to swallow all the things, and the tremors has very, very limited, gone down to less than 60%. There was 40% improvement in the Parkinson state overall. And in the body talk session, you also ask the client to whether further body talk session is required. So it came out that the next session should be done after 2 weeks. So this is the body who told this. Since I was busy, I forgot about it. And they were also improving, so they also forgot about it. Then again his symptom worsened, and then he told, I think body talk 2 weeks ka aapka pending hai, aap wapis se le lijiye session. Maine baat kiya, us baat karne ke baad hi uske symptom, phone pe baat kiya, uske baad unke symptom improve kiye. Then again I done the body talk, and he is again still fine. Again he started having difficulty in swallowing. So how how it's working, I still have no answer. But yes, it's the structured intuition which can help. Yeah.
But did you clear any blocks or what did you do in that?
Yes. What came out to me in this, basically he was a he's a nuclear power scientist. So in whole life, he was very, very rigid. He was working continuously 16 to 18 hours without focusing any, either in the body, either into the relationship. घर पे से उनको कोई मतलब नहीं था. So he was a man of ethics and he was a man of principles. So when you become too rigid in your emotional things, so that can ultimately express in all in rigidness in your body also. So actually that was the reason that came out in that
rigidity.
So rigidity in terms of, it's like it's good to have principles, but if you lose complete flexibility, then there may be chance you lose flexibility of your body as well. Yes.
So, here a diagnostic form, we do neurotransmitter test also.
Yeah.
Serotonin, GABA, DHA, cortisol and other.
Yeah, exactly.
So, in few of the patients, what we found that, when we did the test, the report was there, the markers was, you know, somewhat dopamine was high, serotonin was low, something
yeah.
like that. And the therapeutic action that they were taking, they were on certain kind of, maybe you can say supplements.
Mm.
Like 1 gram of magnesium and 3 grams of this,
yeah.
And therapeutic action was given to them by certain medical practitioners, but that didn't work out. So I know certain patients, I know certain people who are suffering from these kind of arrhythmic markers. So can this body talk help them?
Yes. Basically, what happens is even body talk also we usually find out some molecules. Like in some patients, I find serotonin. You also find some dopamine. I found the GABA. Because if we go into detail of pituitary, it came out to that hormone and it came out to what medical level also. So yes, if we go in detail in that way, everything can work. So there is no doubt about
See,
it.
You can go as deep into the cell
as possible,
as your knowledge permits.
Yeah.
And we do now, we have this epigenetics that I practice and we work a lot on the epigenes, which everybody now knows that there's no junk DNA in the body. It's epigenes. And scientifically, if you go to work on that, I don't know how many years it will take. But intuitively, we do work on epigenes.
So there are two cancer markers, apoptotic and TKD1 cells.
Yes.
So can these cancer markers, if somebody is having high value for this, can also be brought down? I mean, they are
We can silence the markers. You see, if the markers are making your DNA, your gene active, then by body talk, certain methods, we silence the markers. We must find out what is it, methyl DNA, is histone, or what type of marker. We find out how many markers. Every marker will have a different method to silence, which the body tells us. And we silence those markers, so the DNA will remain, but the expression won't be there.
So one of the therapeutic action what the medical practitioner advised them was, do a food allergy test, IgG, and then to reduce the inflammation.
Yeah, there are many other ways, but this is our way. What do you talk
about? Basically, all know about this one thing, that everything is there in everybody. All the allergens, all the cancer cells, we all harboring everything in our body. But it's all about, in somebody they got expressed, in somebody they got suppressed. It's all about circumstances and emotions and your body immunity, your environment in which you live in. It's like, so everything has a work upon, it's not like one thing is you have that marker which is actually causing the cancer. So everybody has a marker value, everybody has a fungus, everybody has a virus, everybody has a cancer cells. So after that expression or that combination of so many things, we call it polymorphic inheritance, we call it.
मैं पहले बीपी के लिए और कई बीमारियों के लिए उनके पास गई थी और तब से ही मैं उन्हीं के ट्रीटमेंट में हूँ. पिछले एक महीने से मुझे पाइल्स से बड़ी परेशानी हो रही थी, बहुत पेट में दर्द हो रहा था. तो मैं उनको दिखाने गई तो उन्होंने बताया कि एक बॉडी टॉक एक तकनीक है जो कि मैं करता हूँ और उससे आपको काफ़ी रिलीफ मिलेगा. तो मैंने पहले तो नाम सुना नहीं था इस चीज़ का, पर मुझे अच्छा लगा कि भाई चलो उसको भी देख लेते हैं. तो उन्होंने फिर मेरे को एक जगह लेटने के लिए बोला तो मैं लेट गई और लेटने के बाद उन्होंने बॉडी से पता नहीं कैसे क्या मालूम किया, बॉडी से ही मतलब निकाला कि आपको ये डिजीज है, ये इस तरह की आपकी परेशानी है, आपको है क्या। मेरे एक महीने पहले उन्होंने दिखाया कि आपको कोई फ्रैक्चर हुआ है क्या कॉलर बोन में, तो हाँ उनका मैं गिरी थी तो मैं तो सरप्राइज रह गई, हैरान हो गई कि मुझे कैसे पता चला, मैंने तो बताया नहीं डॉक्टर साहब को। उन्होंने कहा कि आपको कुछ ऐसा भी है जैसे आपको लगता है कि मुझे कोई प्यार नहीं करता, तो मुझे कई बार फील होता है, होता था कि मुझे कोई प्रेम नहीं करता, मैं तो सबको करती हूँ, मुझे ऐसा नहीं मिलता। तो उन्होंने इस तरह से मेरी फिर हीलिंग की। हीलिंग के बाद उन्होंने कहा कि भाई जैसे हीलिंग आपकी मैं कर रहा हूँ तो आपके जैसे कुछ इमोशंस हैं वो बॉडी के द्वारा बाहर, इमोशंस के द्वारा बाहर निकलेंगे, तो आप परेशान मत होना, मुझे बता दिया था पहले ही। तो हीलिंग के बाद में जब घर आई और दूसरे दिन कुछ वैसे इमोशंस वगैरह हो गए मेरे को, तो मैंने उसके बाद मैंने देखा कि मैं कुछ बेटर फील कर रही हूँ, ऐसा ऐसी कोई दिक्कत मुझे नहीं आ रही, सारी शरीर मेरा ठीक हो गया, पेट दर्द भी मेरा चला गया। मैं हैरान थी कि ऐसा कैसे हो सकता है कि ऐसा कोई तकनीक हो, बॉडी टॉक नाम की पहली बार सुना था, तो मेरा एक्सपीरियंस तो बहुत अच्छा रहा। अगर मैं तो ये मन करती हूँ कि सभी लोग इस तरह से इस चीज को मतलब अगर देखें करके और दिखाएं और करवाएं तो बहुत उनको अच्छा महसूस होगा। मैं फिर सरप्राइज हूँ, हैरान हूँ, बहुत ही अच्छी तकनीक है।
So basically, she had diarrhea and piles and pain abdomen for 1 month. Then I ran the session and the same like Anshul, that she also started having severe diarrhea after that body talk. It lasted for 1 day, but after that her piles and pain abdomen was gone completely. So and the things came out to be she had some issue with some allergies and then. She had issue in active memory and belief system. It pop up very very frequently, like active memory, because active memory is just like Saraj told, is the emotionally charged memory. Those memory who have some emotion attached with them. So she had some issue with her father also. Her father died 20 years back. So she was still remembering them, and she always feel that I am also always the giver. Nobody respect the same love what I have given to them. So. In that way, she was always, you feel deficient of love. You feel like something, I am a bad person, or I am something as someone has cursed me. So she was like, ke bas tumhe dena hai, tumhe koi pyar zindagi mein nahi milne wala. Is type se she has told me. So everything is possible with the body talk. So, yeah. No, no, no. First of all, this is all complementary. My basic thing is like I will give the treatment. I am giving allopathy, I am giving Ayurveda, I am giving. Mostly, I am using the diet therapy basically. I am changing the diet a lot of every patient. For me, food is medicine. So, but yes, it helped me to pick up more things, more into more deeper way that can heal or somehow change the emotional aspect of that disease also. Yes.
Okay, so essentially, if you have to do research, you will need to. How do you?
That's a challenge in private practice.
Even
I'm a practitioner
at the hospital. They also told me that you are giving allopathy, homeopathy, and Ayurveda to a single patient at a single time. I am doing that for last maybe 9 months now.
Not by yourself.
Yeah, it's not by myself. I have Ayurveda doctors, homeopathy doctors, yoga doctors with me.
So all working with you.
All working with me in the department. Then. But they asked me ke how to prove it, which one is working. There is no way to prove. And it's not my intention to prove. My intention to heal the person.
Right.
And it doesn't matter ke which is working. But if some combination is working, I will go with the combination.
And we have a patient sitting who is, if you can, because it helps to know somebody who is sitting there. And
I haven't done any body talk.
But I
used to go to Ishi first as a nutritionist, and I've had diabetes for almost 27 years, and just in the last 2 months it's cured. It's cured as in the range is in the normal range, and I think it's with some medication that you have added to my medication, which I used to have before, and complete diet control.
And insulin is stopped.
Insulin is stopped.
15
yes.
minutes of insulin off.
Insulin, I used to, because hypoglycemia happens with insulin, anybody who's on insulin knows, and that is the most dangerous feeling you can have because you don't know how to control it. So with the insulin gone, that has gone forever.
So that's her culture, Rapeshi Khosla, that she had
she had combined
that what she is doing and along with some techniques of medicine so that people can be happy. Yeah.
Essentially
and,
because you can do the medical management,
yeah.
Which is something I don't know. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, exactly.
So doctors who have open mind. Also, I mean, to answer your question that just to validate for ourselves, you know, if the patient has hit a roadblock, now the further improvement is not happening, like the Parkinson's
yeah.
case, you've not added another medicine. And then the patient improves, so we know for ourselves, but it is a challenge. And it has always been a challenge for us in private practice to publish research and, you know, to even genuinely say, if somebody puts me on a stage and say, how can you prove it? I cannot prove it.
Basically, is the issue is like the good thing about body talk, mind can play.
So what we can do is have a set of patients who have, for instance, I did a level with her, and this is not the first time she's come to me, Alpati.
Yeah.
She came to me a long time
ago,
and she
years
did
ago.
All of this, and then she wrote her back, and then she came back. And so we know that the diet did up to that much, and then further happened because of other.
Yeah.
Yeah,
can I just comment this thing, because there are too many doctors here for doing and research. You see, this is quantum science, right? You cannot prove. You are not supposed to be able to prove. Once you start proving this, it is no more body talk.
Exactly.
Yeah? So you know something about quantum science and you will understand that. There is no proof. In fact, if those who have been studying quantum science, you know that mere observation of a problem creates the change. You don't need to do anything.
Yeah. So there's another patient you'll be getting, there's a boy, Manav Bhatia, has he contacted
you? So it's like basically, good thing about body talk, body cannot lie. Mind can play the game. Whatever the person is coming to you, He may be having something different, but ultimately he's speaking something else. Like, mujhe ye hai, mujhe aisa hua. But he's not telling the exact reason what is the causing disease. It's like one patient came to me 2 months back, and she was having headache. And mujhe bolti, 4-5 saal se headache hai. So, you have everybody, we all know ki we will treat the person either as a chronic headache or we treat as a migraine. We give some medicine, some painkiller, and that's fine. But then I did the body talk session and it came out to be that for last 4 to 5 years, she used to live in joint family and for last four, and then she parted from the family and now there is a nuclear family. So she is feeling that loneliness for last 4 to 5 years, which is actually causing headache. So you cannot take that information from the patient. But once you get to know about the patient in detail while doing body talk, yes, you can address it that way. You should meet your family much more, like, so that your headache may improve. So basically, body talk best part is you're just dealing with body. Most of the session, patient usually lie down completely without speaking anything. And in my session, some patient even mislept, and they have started snoring also while doing session. So it doesn't matter. Okay, so now
the plan is that the population, if there is one volunteer, he can do a demo session as well, keeping the personal details to himself. He would pick it up, not necessarily whatever is trivial. Dr. Rachna said,
yeah,
so,
she raised her hand.
Okay, so maybe we can have a check.
Yeah, anyone.
Okay,
okay.
So we can do two demos otherwise.
It will take
30-40
minutes.
The simpler the person, the easier my job.
Both of them are very complex. I can vouch for that.
If there are any more questions.
Yeah. Yeah, so I mean, we can take
we can
10
finish
minutes
with the questions and then we can continue
the
with the session. Those who want to watch
the
session, those who want to eat.
So
maybe.
You will immediately feel a change, right? And during the session, we also advise you, the body tells us when you need to do the follow-up, maybe 2 weeks' time or 3 weeks' time. But a lot of people after the first session, they feel a little bit better, then they don't bother, they don't do the follow-up. So, see, if the factors that made you uncomfortable or gave you the disorder, if those factors are there, you'll get the disorder again, right? So you need to, and every session is different. The first session will probably scan the problems at the surface, the number one priorities. The second time you come, then it will go deeper and deeper. So you need a couple of sessions to take care of chronic problems. But the first session itself will show the change. I'll just give you an example. Generally, if I have a person suffering from cancer and he comes for a session with me, the priority of cancer does not come up. You know why? Because the body is not prepared that the cancer should be addressed. The body needs to balance first. You have to prepare the environment, you have to prepare the body, you have to prepare its immune system. Maybe in the second session or third session, then the body will tell, okay, now hit the cancer. And we do whatever is required. So this is what happens. So your body tells you. So yeah, for chronic ailments, you need a couple of sessions here. But you will start feeling a change immediately after the first session.
How do we make sure that the fear is gone? I will symptomatically start to feel better.
The fear is gone.
But it could come back.
If it's an emotion, you will come to know because you will get a release. You get a release.
But in case I'm subjected to the same thing, let's say I had a grievance with someone and finally you help me, he releases it and the person comes again and does something again. I think that emotion can come back.
The same emotion won't come back, but another
one.
Yeah, you see, in the active memory, the emotions are lodged from earlier time, right? So we can diffuse those, but there's no guarantee further emotion will not come to you. But if you take regular body talk sessions and you do the excess programming, the 5-6 techniques that we teach, your Vechi, you know.